And I am back. I have been refueled and I'm ready for more. Whoops, I had the mic turned around. That made scenes awkward. Sorry about that. Also, it's awkward to talk about this while running into him.
Did you enjoy meeting your memories?
Yeah, it was good to see everyone. But what do you really want from me?
What do you have to give?
Dad ass. It's Axel!
Hello.
What do you want?
No hogging the hero.
Then perhaps you'd like to test him.
Perhaps I would. My show now, Keyblade Master. Who am I? Oh, my name's Axel. Got it memorized?
Sure.
Good. You're a quick learner. So, Sora, now that we're getting to know each other better... Don't you go off and die on me now.
Well, we already had another boss fight. This is going to be our first boss fight against someone who uses a deck like we do. He even has slights, too. Always keep your ones on handy for that. He used his zero. It is entirely possible to completely dex a boss out if they go and use their, well, slight way too often. There we go. And that's generally why you usually have like a zero or two at the very start and at the very end. That still nailed him with it. Although, looky, I probably could have taken him out of that attack with my Donald card there. But of course, this fight is really just to get you used to the idea that the enemy can have a full deck, too. Yeah, see, he's already starting to have some issues with his deck running out of cards. Hell, I don't think any of his cards are over 5. Yay, level up. And we learned a new spell, fire. Which also means we're not learning lightning until we get another one of these fights. Creates more worlds for us to fight in, of course. Kiba's back and he's got his peanut!
It looks like the card you used when you made Traverse Town.
Then I guess we're gonna need it to keep going.
That's right.
Of course he hasn't died yet. We've barely begun the game.
Did you really think after that introduction I would give up oh so easily?
Exactly.
You were testing us.
And you passed. Congratulations, Sora. You're ready now. Ready to take on Castle Oblivion. You will need to follow your memories. Trust what you remember and seek what you forget. Then you will find someone very special.
You mean King Mickey and Riku?
You will just have to give some more thought to who it is that's most important to you. Our most precious memories lie so deep within our hearts that they're out of reach. But I'm sure that you can find yours, Sora.
Why me?
You have lost sight of the light within the darkness, and it seems that you've forgotten that you forgot.
Light within...
Kingdom Hearts?
Would you like me to give you a hint?
Yes, trust the strange man in black with spiky hair.
Sora, do you need it?
I'm gonna figure it out for myself. If you're in my way.
Watch out, people. Donald's gonna operate here.
Good answer. Just what I'd expect from the Keyblade Master. But be forewarned. When your sleeping memories awaken, you may no longer be who you are.
Bum bum bum. Holy cards, Batman.
Yeah.
Screw your statues. Yep, there's 13 of the bastards. Oh, I sure I can, Donald. Even their pots don't break. And while that seems annoying, but it's actually fairly handy if you want to go grind or something.
What's wrong, Jiminy?
Well, you see, what Axel said back there worries me. What could he have meant by, you may no longer be who you are?
Because he believes in nurture versus nature.
How can I be anyone else?
Of course. Still, can't be too careful.
Yep. Feels like just about anything could happen here in Castle Oblivion. Oh, yeah. Now I remember.
We'll be okay. Whatever it is they're cooking up, we'll be able to handle it together.
Just get lots and lots of post-it notes.
Of course we will. Like that creepy castle we explored together. The one with all those weird contraptions.
When was that?
I can't remember. What was it, Todd?
Gorge. Oh, it was, Holly? Holler. Sorry, I can't remember.
Stop goofing around.
Goofy, sure you didn't make it up?
Apparently you've already forgotten that this castle takes away your memories every floor you go up. Card of Memories. Already we have another cutscene. So, we can go to the first floor, and that's it. Not much point to doing that now. Kiba, you look so silly with that giant stuffed peanut in your mouth. Now, if we had more people talking in the chat, I'd actually put this up to a vote. However, there's something I want from the Olympus Colosseum, so that's where we're going first. Colloseum Survival Cup. Well, this sounds new. Was Jiminy the only one who can read? Or is it all written in Greek? What do you think, Kiba? I think we can win. In other words, the areas we lead up to the Key of Beginnings door. Hi, Hades. Perfect. Perfectly infuriating! Yep. Hi, Cloud. Welcome back. You're looking as belty as ever. Well, I guess instead of helping him look for Aeris, he's asking him to restore his memories. Don't know if Hades can. Worth 7 experience points instead of like 3 from it's Power Wilds. We'll just keep on breaking our own cards over each other's heads. Holy crap, I've got a lot of buddy cards already. The more Donald cards you stack up, the stronger his magic is. Like, if it was a rank, like, 3 cards, then I would have to be casting, he'd be casting the Aga level spells. We got a blue card, and it's Smuggle Room! Yes, finally! Oh, I'm so happy. This is better than a 2 Kingdom Key. Yeah. Oh, dang it. I jumped into it instead of actually hitting. And damn it, we got large bodies. And you thought large bodies could be annoying before. Finally, I just killed something. you also might notice the enemy's decks have actually improved quite a bit. They got a lot more 3s and 4s. Which is a bad thing for me. We don't really have that many key cards that are over 4. There we go. A roulette room! Actually, roulette rooms are pretty awesome. Instead of just getting a card at the end like we have been, it'll actually just give us like a... Where's my suggestion for you? Basically like a little wheel thing spins around. And when a card you want shows up, you can just hit X and bam, you got it. Makes it so much easier to get to like Moogle room cards and stuff like that. Oh, and a premium room. We haven't actually seen premium cards yet. Oh yeah, like it's really gonna just stick to be one the shadow. These four are starting to become the average for their cards, which makes my 3 and lower cards kind of worthless. Donald. Boom! Donald is definitely a very good card in the early game. Oh, that's the end. Here we go. Apparently we did, although it was less than a room, really. Didn't realize that was a requirement to kick someone's butt. I mean, if you don't let anybody in because they ain't heroes, then you're not gonna have much of a fight. So it'd just be us versus Hercules? Got me over a barrel? Was that really a phrase back in ancient Greece? Sup, Cloud? Do they regularly only have less than three groups going around? Well, only three groups. Doesn't seem like much of a tournament if you've only got three people competing, really. It's a race! I'm winning! And Cloud just walks. Now, as I recall, the key to guidance in this world actually does give us a boss fight. For our first room, I want a Moogle room. I will admit, I do like the effect they have for the cards opening the door. It just looks neat to me. Now, of course, first thing we gotta check around for is any items we can break, etc. Huh. Dang it, Moogle rooms tend to, like, not have much of them. Yep! Oh, we got a new Keyblade! Oh, do we need these? Ooh, nice, we got six. And a five, and a few more fours. Yeah, that one wasn't so great. Sweet, a nine! Might as well pick up some magic, too. Oh, we got a zero cure! Although, honestly, zero's not that great for cure. And I guess we got a premium blizzard. Sick. Yes, we can also sell our cards. Well, at least the ones we don't want. I should probably ditch that for me too. Okay. So yeah, that's why I wanted all those Moogle points for. We can actually make a decent deck now. Okay, all those threes are going bye-bye. Whoops. And, of course, the 9 is getting tossed in. And we'll toss in our second 0 up there. There we go. Looks like a much more competent deck. Let's actually ditch these. They're too low to really be useful. I just did that before because we actually had the CP for it. Okay. Let's stick Simba here. And a couple fires. And let's rearrange the cure to right here. There we go. So much better looking. Shortcut this. There we go. Right. Okay, yeah, everything is above the potion. Alright. Should be doing a lot better in combat now. There's a four. Oh, we can do the roulette room so I can actually show this off. Apparently we can hit them from the front to stun them like the others. Oh, dang it. premium bonuses or, well, that's what that P thing I just picked up, or a mixed bag to me. Why? Well, you'll see in a second. Oh, this is the map where that's starting. There we go. I grabbed a premium bonus there. Oh well. Sometimes a big P will drop in the middle of combat. If you pick it up, you get a premium bonus, and that basically lets you make one of those gold flashy cards. Okay, it looks like I got it again. It's so much better when you have cards over 5. Seriously, I'm having no problems now that I've completely done, and I keep on using up my 0. Hell, there's even a slight later that requires you to use 3 zeros up. Let's see, what would be a good one to pick up? Probably a new Moogle card. I think this is the highest level one they got. But yeah, now I don't need to worry about random chance giving me something like my Moogle cards. Ooh, nice, a rank 8 Olympian. Throwing all their cards they could at me to try and break that attack. Okay. I was messing up my visuals. The P that drops is what gives us the roulette choice up for cards and all that. Spell that refuses to miss. Also, as you may have noticed, there aren't any actual, like, stats for damage to scale off of. It basically is all based around the cards. So, while, like, Kingdom Key that we're wielding now, oh, you did not just knock out my Moogle points. Anyway, as I was trying to say, and I didn't. What was I trying to say? Another Olympian, nice. Oh yeah, we're talking about card strengths. So, like, while our Kingdom Key for now is, well, it's our bread and butter, we're not really going to be able to use anything else for quite some time heavily. So until that point, we gotta use it. But eventually we are going to have to ditch it just for the fact that it does fairly poor damage compared to the other key blades. Power. to watch for that P better, don't I? Admittedly, I picked up the two cards I really wanted, but still. Other kind of weird things is how hitting R1 makes me go to the left on my card instead of to the right. They could be opposite. There we go. Got ourselves a roulette. Okay, what card do we pick now? Honestly, with these kind of cards, I try to get as many blue cards as I can. Just because they're usually a bit rarer than the other ones. I mean, we've noticed a whole whopping, like, what, two that have actually dropped for me? And I half expect that Moogle shop card we got initially was forced in. Oh, there's our roulette. Courage. Next up, I'll probably be using one of our calm bounty cards that I've been collecting. Every world, pretty much, well, you want to go and try and use the calm bounty at some point. Ooh, I saw a zero. Yes. This will let us get another roulette set going. As I recall, they had actually added the roulette cards into this version of the game, and they weren't available before. Martial Awakening 2 seems so handy, doesn't it? I think we've gotten everything here. No, maybe not enemies. Although at least the roulette rooms have a 2-star to them. Up. There we go. I love how much magic damage magic does compared to how it was in Kingdom Hearts 1. I mean, seriously, I hardly ever really used magic for the sword because it never seemed to do that much damage. But now... Okay, let's see. What do we get? What do we get? We can actually make a save point now. As you can read, we gotta put in enough cards that totals 15. There we go. And once you actually do that, you don't need to worry about anything else, really. Like, I mean, like I just quit out of there, it's still counted as being filled. Okay. Oh, well, let's go fight Cloud. Kicking your spiky hair butt, that's what. It's kind of funny how they don't use actual boss music for this fight. Too bad I don't have guard on me anymore. But then again, we can just break his cards. And as you might notice, this is an actual card duel. Oh no, you don't. Ah, dang it. Crap. Yeah, he certainly is very slight happy, isn't it? Although Cloud has a much bigger deck than Axel did. He used up a slight just to crap. You to actually use up your slight, dang it. There we go. Didn't even need to heal. I am getting close to death though, so I probably should heal soon. It's a very crappy high potion. But didn't we beat his butt? Why didn't he at least get knocked unconscious or something? Come on. Still haven't actually made a room into a calm bounty. Where did those cards bounce? Oh, we got a zero fire, okay, that could actually be handy, and a four kingdom key. Not too bad. finally is easy to abuse magic to kill large bodies now. No, it's easier than before, at least. Oh, we got another roulette room. Nice. We need all of the CP. Aww. We got our red card to pop up just in time for me to miss it. You got a 2-for-1 on that one. Freeze. Wrong target, dude. Yeah. And we got Teeming Darkness 0. Able to kill shadows in one full combo anymore. Treasure rooms. You need to get a very special card that really doesn't show up often enough, in my opinion. And there's one in every world, and they usually guard something really, really nice. Oh yeah, and I also forgot to mention something about, like, the Moogle's wares. Basically, all cards are legal as long as we've actually seen or unlocked them. Like how we can now get fire from the Moogle shops now that we picked it up from Axel. I want my combat and bounty, dang it. So-called bounty rooms are basically just like the Moogle rooms. Ooh, nice. So they got a nice big chest in the middle. And we got a new slight. Pretty simple one to do. Let's see. Where are we on the map? So we want to go through this door. And let's stick a one card in there. All right, let's do this. Because that makes it okay. Hercules, oh my. He was? Pack your pita. Just making up these rules as you go, aren't you? It's where Hades looks like he's about to fall asleep in the actual combat. Oh crap, that's a zero. I mean, not a zero, an eight. Dang it.
Take that.
Yeah, Hades actually has a pretty decent deck on him.
Take that. That's it. That's it. Take that.
I did really need a double healing, Donald.
Take that. Take that.
Fire.
That's it.
Ah, crap, he activated. Things aren't looking too bad yet.
Take that.
Reload my cards.
Take that.
Oh. Yeah. Hey, I forgot he starts with a friggin' elixir.
Take that. Take that.
We don't get access to those till like take way that. Later.
Take that.
Although at least he finally reloaded take so that. His fire boost is gone. Dang it. Oh, that might have worked. Got it.
Isn't happening.
So yeah, Hades really isn't too bad. I mean, this is the first fight, first world we've created, and I've already cleared it. And now we get the Hades card. You also get something else that's very, very special. They are? Well, given the fact that this whole world will disappear the second I leave this floor, I don't think so. And good lord, Jiminy is a lot more talkative in this game than he was in Kingdom Hearts 1. Of course you say that now. Technically, he kind of is now. I mean, given how this world works. Cloud 4. Oh, yeah. The triple cloud slate is something else. I'll say that. Now, Cloud is one of the best cards in the game. Yeah. Well, at least he was in the Game Boy Advance version. Here, the bigger arenas makes it a lot easier for him to miss with his basic attacks ones, making his big version pretty much his best one. And oh god, I'm being raided by Avalanche Wolf. Oh no, he's trying to do my minigame. Yeah, if you want to use raid, you have to put a number at the end. Let's see, I can't remember if there was a boss fight off on floor 2. No, the raid command isn't broken, it's the minigame one. You have to actually bet a number before you do it.
That creepy castle that I was talking about earlier. I know I didn't imagine it. Because that was the castle where Sora had to use the Keyblade to free Kairi's heart.
Oh yeah, I did turn into a Heartless, didn't I?
And I was so worried. How could I ever forget that?
Oh, Ankbot? Yeah, I'm using Ankbot.
Then what's it called?
Every word. I finished the first volume right before we got to this castle. Now then, if I can just find it. Oh.
No kidding. I've completely filled out that journal in the Kingdom Hearts 1.
Let's have a look. Oh, how could it be?
What's the matter?
Oh, my entries. They're gone.
Welp.
Every page is blank.
What do we do?
Well, that would have made it way too easy for them to actually look at stuff, look at the journal and remember what they did.
All that hard work is gone.
Aw, poor Jiminy Cricket.
The journal's blank. What's going on?
Of course, we'll actually have to remember everything. Now we meet a mysterious blonde girl who's drawing something.
Something's
drawing. No!
What if it's more things? Goofy was telling us about another castle we'd been to, but none of us really remembers it. Do you think? Could it be that we don't remember because we're losing our memories?
That's what he said at the start.
Hold on. Remember what that mystery fella said? You misplaced to find is to lose, and to lose is to find. Must have been our memories he was talking about losing.
Yep.
So if we keep going, we'll lose more. Guess it really is Castle Oblivion.
So the higher we go, the more we'll forget.
Yep.
Riku and Kairi too.
Do you want to go back?
Don't worry, fellers. We might forget about where we've been or what things we've seen, but we won't forget who our friends are.
I don't know.
Come on, Sora. When you turned into a Heartless, did you forget about me and Donald?
Of course I didn't.
There you go. No matter what happens, you won't forget your friends.
Oh.
I wouldn't be too
You're
sure
right.
about that.
Thank you, Goofy.
So if this wasn't here just to make you forget about your friends, then we have nothing to be scared of. Let's go!
Suddenly, Donald forgets how to talk.
But when I turned into a Heartless, who was the one who took forever to notice and kept clobbering me?
How come you couldn't forget about that?
You make it sound like it was his fault. Oh, looks like Avalanche Wolf won the minigame, even though he kind of left immediately afterwards. Don't know how that works for the rewards. Although I guess it's saved in Inkbot, so it should be fine. And before we move any further, let's head back to Traverse Town and use up another one of our Calm Bounty cards. Because like I said, every world has a good treasure that you gotta get from it. After the initial one, you just get a random card normally. Man, that Shadow really wants my booty. To another level, at least.
Heal. Fire. Fire. Freeze. Freeze.
A sleeping dart. Those ones are definitely easy mode material, I'd say. They basically just make every enemy on the map asleep right at the start of the, and they never wake up unless you actually like smack them yourself. Yet more meeting grounds. All right, our treasure is fire? Huh. Yeah. Could have sworn that. Oh, wait. I think I need to do something else before I can actually get one from here. Yeah. Crap, I forgot about that. Ooh, now that was a nice gear. we're getting out of here. Time to move on up. The power of attack cards when low on HP. Probably not going to use that. Slightly extends the range of attack cards. Not sure if that's really worth that much CP. And now we have a cloud. Although my next major usage should probably be to get a second cure in the deck.